change to enter the parable of the servant, the three guys that you were given some gifts, you know, talents. And the one he went and he worked hard with his talent and he got to double it. And the another one did the same, but the third one came and they, wow, this guy, I was reading, I said, goodness, he had a completely wrong understanding about God, who God was. You know, there was lies what he was thinking about God. And let's read very quickly here. I think this is important for us to get to the point here. Luke 19 and verse 20. Then another servant came and said, Sir, here is your mine. I have kept you laid away in a piece of cloth.
Wow.
I was afraid of you because you are a hard man. You take out what you did not put in and reap what you did not sow. What a lie. Can you see how many of us can be deceived as well? How many lies we are believing about God? The enemy is throwing us lies. Your God is not good. What we said to Job? Where is your God? You know, huh? Where is your God? See the stage that you are, you know? And the work of the enemy is to distort who God is. If you see the Garden of Eden, the first cry was with Eve. God really said. Well, he said, but it's another. You know, can you see how the enemy, he tried to distort the nature of God, to bring lies into our minds. So if we do not believe in what God, who really he is, and his word, then we are lost. Then we were in trouble. And this was the position of this guy, completely wrong idea about who the Father really is. This is not the truth about God. And then there was consequence. We need to know through the Bible and through our time of the prayer is the only way that we can know God. You cannot. Job, he said, before I heard about you, but now I know you by intimacy. And this is the way that God wants you to know him. It's not only what people has been saying. What we preach here is good because it helps. You know, but it's not just about what people are saying. God wants you to know him through intimacy. God wants you to have a personal relationship with him, to know his heart, to understand. Even though people are saying, where is your God? Why your problem hasn't been solved? Where is your God? And you say, I know my Redeemer lives. And in the right time, he'll come and he'll rescue me. Yo! Come on, church. We need to know God in this way. That we are not scared of tomorrow. We are not scared of the dry time season. We are not scared when the hurricane is going around. We are not scared when the parliament cannot get anywhere. We are not scared if the Brexit is coming. With the deal or without no deal. We are not scared because we know our regime and live.
Amen.
We have a mighty and powerful God who is able to care, to provide, to sustain us. He's a rock. He's a rock for those who trust him.
Amen.
And this is our God. We get to know someone else by seeing what he does with his life. And through the Bible, we can see what God has done. See what God has done. Scripture is going to show you what God has done in the past and what he is doing today through our relationship, through the testimony, through our own lives. We can see what God is about. Meet him and doing things together. This is the way that we can know someone else. It's first of all, we see what the person does and also meeting the person and doing things together. Sometimes we say hi to someone else and say, wow, what an amazing person. Oh my goodness, she's so amazing. But when we start to live with the person, then it's gone. You know, when he got married with him, he said, wow, she's amazing. What a holy woman. Goodness. What? She's amazing. And 3 years later, hey, oh, it's not what I really saw in the beginning. And then we get to know people when we start to live. In Brazil, they have a say, if you want to know someone else, eat a bag of salt with them. Oh. And then you know. I don't know if it should mean anything.
It should mean spend a long time.
Spend a long time with the person and then you discover who they are. You know, and spend time with God is the way that we know who God really is. The same is true about God. Through the history of the Bible, we get to know Him because they show us what God did and what is important to Him. The Bible teaches us what is important for God. And it's the reason that Jesus told to the Pharisees, you are narrow because you do not know the word of God and the power of the God. We need both. We need the power and we need the word. There are people who are desperate about power, but power can destroy you. We need the word of God because the word is the rock. The word is the thing that will sustain us when the storms come, and we'll be able to stand firm because we know God. Yeah, through prayer, we will know Him in an intimate relationship, in a personal relationship. We need to know Him. And yes, the way that we start to know God is through being born again. This is the first step to engage in a relationship with God. We need to accept Him as the Lord and the Savior of our lives. And when you are born again, you are born to God. And your spirit is alive. And your spirit is desiring, you know, to relate with God. And that is when everything began. It's when we give our life to Jesus, we are born again. And then we engage our relationship. And when you are born again, you know, because you say, oh, I am a believer now. I am born again and it has been done. It has been done because your sins are forgiven. You are connected with God. But a baby, you got a baby. And the baby is born. And this baby is going to be baby forever. Don't feed the baby. No, don't feed. Don't give water. Don't give milk. He's a baby. Has a baby. It's amazing. Can you see? And the baby, what's going to happen? The baby is going to be malnourished. Or the baby is going to die. You know, we need to feed. It's like us as well. When we are born again, we need to feed ourselves. How we feed ourselves? With the word of God. With the prayer, with the fellowship, with the getting together, with the right ground, getting together with the right people who encourage us, who input in our lives, who help us to overcome our difficulties, and correct us as well, and help us to be the people that God has designed us to be. Read your Bible and have a life of prayer. It will help us to know God and to live a life of victory. Let's change the history. Amen. Let's impact the moment. For this very moment you have been born. For the moment of Brexit, God brought you to England. You know, for this very moment where Boris Johnson doesn't know, no one knows. You know, no one knows. No one can do this job. You know, only with God's intervention and wisdom. Yes. And let's change it. We can change. We can cry out before the Father for all wisdom. Who can give you wisdom for someone else, even for Boris Johnson, for someone else. Give you wisdom. Give you wisdom for you as well, your own trial, your own tribulation. So make a way when there is no way. Open doors when there is no door. You know, provide when you cannot see. Make a miracle when the doctor said there is no one can do anything. That's right. You know? Let's stand in prayer and let's change our generation. Let's change the world that we are living in. Let's change our community. Let's change Luton and make this place a better place where everyone wants to desire to live here and to buy houses here, where big business want to invest in Luton, because there is a church of God that is spread, that church of God that is standing, a church of God that understands their own business and they are standing for the kingdom of God to be manifested. Amen. Amen. God bless you. And God bless my life. God help us. God help NCF to be a light on the hill and make Jesus too big to ignore. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Amazing. Great encouragement. Let's move on in prayer. Let's make the prayer meetings the biggest meetings in this church. Friday. Amen. Friday you are here. Pray. Let's pray together. The power of prayer is amazing. Yeah, you need to engage on that and to get there everything that we need. Yes. And I want to say thank you so much if someone came for the first time. Thank you so much for coming. God bless you. And I hope that you come again and again and be part of this family. Yeah, we have a men's conference soon. This comes up today. We have the men's conference. Most of the men didn't sign yet, but please do it if you did.